Hello there, this is Sue at Hometown to Homestead Gal Gardener, and today is Apple Day. I have about two-thirds of a box of apples left, and I'm going to be making a pie and a little bit of an apple onion relish, applesauce, and I have some that were put away in the refrigerator for crisp eating. Anyway, let's get started. Into this pot, I'm going to, I need to take you down a little bit lower here. I'm going to dice up 8 apples. I tried to pick some ones that had a lot of red on their skin, just for the color. And then I'm going to do 3 or 4, I have to see the size of them, medium onions. I'm going to dice those up. So after I get all this cut up, I'll come back and show you some more. Okay, very, very watery, teary eyes. Down to my last half of an onion to chop here. My onions, I'm getting to the bottom of my basket, and so most of them are small. So I did 5 to put in here. So the pot is about 2/3 of the way full of apple, roughly chopped to 1/4 of an inch. And another 1/3 with onions. Now I'm gonna go get the seasonings. Okay, now in case my vinegar has lost some of its acidity, I'm going to add 1, 2, 3 teaspoons of citric acid to this whole pot. And I'm going to add 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 whole cloves to the pot. Half teaspoon of celery salt, celery seed. Teaspoon of Himalayan sea salt. Half a teaspoon of allspice. New container. It smells yummy. I'm going to put half, 1 and a half, 2 teaspoons of cinnamon, 1 and a half teaspoons of ground cumin to accent that onion that's in there. My brown sugars are sticking together lately. Humid summer we've had. 1 cup packed brown sugar. And check that. Yeah. I'm going to do 1 cup. Apple cider vinegar. Now this will go on the stove. Bring it up to a boiling and cook it down for 20 minutes. Stirring it occasionally, keeping the lid on it so it doesn't splatter all over your kitchen. And once it's cooked down for 20 minutes and the onions get all nice and translucent and everything's blended well together, load it into hot sterilized jars and water bath, I'm using pints, water bath it for 25 minutes. And there's gonna be our apple onion relish. Apple onion relish. Now before I started all of this, I washed these apples up really good. That relish, I kept the skins on and give it some color and just give it a little more texture. Now I'm peeling apples for a quickie apple pie. I have a refrigerated case pie crust because I suck at making pie crust. And so I just wanted to make a nice quickie dessert for my family tonight. I'm saving the skins and cores because I'm going to try my hand at making some pepper jelly. I have some peppers up on the side too, which you need to boil down some skins and cores for the pectin that's in them for this recipe that I'm using. I'm not using the turning apple peeler core thing on this because for apple pie, to me, that makes it a little bit thin. I like my slices a little thicker than that for apple pie. They vary in size. These apples that I'm using are Honeycrisp. And I love the taste of them. We're gonna make all of these delicacies delicious. Let's see. What else did I need to tell you at this point? I cannot remember. Thank you, fibromyalgia. A little brain fade going on there. So I'm just peeling these away for the apple pie. And then I'll season it with some seasonings and sugar and flour and put it into that pie crust and bake it off. So we'll have a nice treat tonight. Now that relish, I patterned that kind off of a corn relish recipe that I did before. And the thought it sounded like it would be good to go with chicken, turkey, pork, you know, with the onions and the apples in it. That'll be a nice little side dish relish thing going on. You can even put it on a sandwich, probably, if you so choose. Cut that one a little wonky. There we go. I'll finish up this apple pie and we'll go on to the next thing. Do you have pet peeves when you're cooking? I sure do, especially with things like apples. I like to cut sometimes these little pockets where the seeds are. I can't stand those when they end up in something like your apple pie. That's just horrible. They're hard and unappealing to the mouth. So I probably take off more apple than I need to, but I can't stand having those things in my end product. That's just me and my pet peeve. Okay, here's all my apples. I'm going to put, let's see, what am I going to do? I'm going to put in this bowl those cutting apples in two. Brown sugar. Half a teaspoon of allspice. Half a teaspoon of Himalayan sea salt to counteract. Sweet. Tablespoon of cinnamon. My measure is a half. Okay, I'm going to get a half a cup of flour in here and a stick of butter and my pie crusts in their dish. I'm going to mix this all up with the apples and the flour, and then I'll cube the butter and put it across the top so that it bakes down in. It'll be lovely, and I'll show you when it's all done. Okay, I'm laughing out loud because I can't make my own pie crust, and I don't make the store-bought ones look much better. Believe it or not, this is the pretty side. But it's going to taste good. And look at how nice and tall that is. Oop, don't throw it on the floor. This is going in the oven. I just got the relish into the water bath canner, and it ended up making 3 pints by the time it cooked down in the pot. It has a nice tangy flavor with the apples and the onions and the spices. It'll be a real good meat relish. Now on to peeling all the rest of the apples for applesauce. This little doohickey is a lifesaver when you want to do a lot of apples for something like applesauce. Except I have to hold mine down because it doesn't stick to my table. It has a suction cup on the bottom, but that part doesn't work for me, so I just hold on to it. Turning and turning and turning and turning and turning. Turn it until it pops all the way through there. Pull it off, and I just take them and break them. Pull it off. Get all these little peels that goes in the jelly pot. And this is the only part I struggle with sometimes, is getting it off the prongs. On to the next one. One of the things I've noticed when loading the apple onto the apple pear liqueur, I find that if you load it onto the prongs from the blossom end, you'll get a straighter core. If you try to do it on the stem end, as you can see, the apples, they grow a little wonky up on that end. And so you'll end up with maybe the core coming out the side near that end. So if you use one of these and you're struggling with it, try the blossom end. There's a little lever back here that you push it and it releases it, and then you can slide it forward. I don't know if you can see how the apple looks like it's wobbling on that, because it's a piece of fruit from nature, and they don't grow perfectly straight. Off it comes, and into the pot. Into the pot. So to the end of apple day, that brings us to 9 pints of applesauce, 4 pints of hot pepper jelly, 6 half pints of apple pepper jelly made with the apple scraps and peels, and plenty of hot pepper. That's going to be very spicy. 3 pints of the apple onion relish, 1 big apple pie, apples in the fridge, and lots of yumminess to come. So apple day is all done. This is Sue at Hometown to Homestead Gal Gardner. Be safe, be happy, be blessed.